Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Thousands of House of Fraser customers have reacted with fury after stores refused to accept the company's own gift vouchers since a takeover by Sports Direct owner Mike Ashley on Friday. The billionaire, who paid £90 million to save the struggling department chain from closing, has come under fire over the weekend after it was revealed his last-minute deal allowed him to dump any responsibility for the pensions of 10,000 staff. But the move, which will see them dumped into the Pension Protection Fund lifeboat scheme and lose up to 10% of their retirement income, is set to be scrutinized by the pensions watchdog. A spokesman said last night, "Our anti-avoidance powers allow us to take action if we think an organization has attempted to avoid obligations to a pension scheme." And last night, as frustration over House of Fraser's refusal to honor gift cards and vouchers grew, it was angrily suggested that alienating loyal customers was not the best start for Mr. Ashley's regime. Mike Ashley has come under fire over the weekend after it was revealed his last-minute deal allowed him to dump any responsibility for the pensions of 10,000 House of Fraser staff. The Sports Direct owner paid £90 million to save the struggling department chain from closing. Signs posted in windows at the department stores had read, "Please be advised that we will not be able to process any gift card transactions. Please accept our apologies for any inconvenience this may cause." One customer contacted the company from Belfast to say he was disgusted that it had rushed to stop accepting gift cards. Another said, "It appears you have stopped honoring House of Fraser vouchers. Not a good start to a new venture, destroying customer loyalty." Writing on the company's Twitter feed, a customer said, "Great that you have been saved, but very upsetting that I now cannot use my £100 gift voucher," while another added, "I haven't been able to use my gift card. I have £100 on it." House of Fraser, which was founded in 1849, has now said that customers will have to post gift cards and vouchers to its head office in London, and replacements will be issued. However, that failed to satisfy customers who fear they will not be honoured or that posting high-value gift cards, which can each hold up to £250, meant using expensive recorded delivery to ensure they reach their destination. One customer questioned who was expected to carry the cost of doing this, writing, "You can't just send gift cards through the post. It's like posting cash. It will have to be sent by special delivery. Are you going to pay for this?" The future of the 59 House of Fraser stores and their 17,000 staff remains up in the air at the moment. It is not clear whether plans by the previous owners to close 31 stores, many inexpensive leased premises across Britain, will go ahead under Mr. Ashley, who founded his budget high street sports chain in 1982. It has also emerged that a 28-year-old former nightclub promoter Michael Murray, who is engaged to Mr. Ashley's daughter Anna, will play a key role in deciding the chains. It has also emerged that a 28-year-old former nightclub promoter will play a key role in deciding the future of House of Fraser. Michael Murray, who is engaged to Mr. Ashley's daughter Anna, is the so-called head of elevation at Sports Direct. A row erupted with Sports Direct shareholders last month when it was revealed Mr. Murray has been paid £5 million since his appointment in 2015, leading to accusations of nepotism. City sources said they expect Mr. Murray to play a major role in attempts to turn House of Fraser department stores into Mr. Ashley's vision of the Harrods of the High Street. However, property analyst Andrew Teacher, managing director of city property firm Blackstock Consulting, questioned his credentials for the role, saying, "It's a bit worrying the future of a 169-year-old institution is in the hands of a 28-year-old without much industry experience." Sports Direct has suggested several House of Fraser stores will be transformed into Mr. Ashley's upmarket flannels designer outlet shops. It is believed that the decision to require House of Fraser customers to send in gift cards to get a replacement will have the effect of reducing the firm's liabilities, because not everyone will do so. It is understood that the decision was taken by executives at Sports Direct, rather than House of Fraser. Sports Direct did not respond to requests for a comment.